So let us look through the content of this presentation. So first we'll be talking about bottom-up parsers, which is also known as shift-reduced parser. Then we'll discuss about LR0 parser, its MCQs, its examples. Next comes SLR1 parser. We'll discuss about its example and its MCQs. Next slide. So I'll be talking about what is bottom-up parser or shift-reduced parser. So bottom-up parser builds the parse tree from leaves to root. Bottom-up parsing can also be determined, can also be defined as an attempt to reduce the input string W to the start symbol of grammar by tracing out the rightmost derivation of W in reverse. So there are certain points regarding bottom-up parsing. So first, it attempts to traverse a parse tree bottom-up, which is post-order traversal. Second, it reduces a sequence of token to the start symbol. Third, at each reduction step, the RHS of a production is replaced with its LHS. Fourth, a reduction step corresponds to the reverse of a rightmost derivation. So this diagram represents the bottom-up parsing. So what is LR parsing? LR parsing, to have an operational shift-reduced parser, we must determine whether a handle appears on top of the stack. Second, the reducing production to be used. Third, the choice of actions to be made at each parsing step. Second comes, LR parsing provides a solution to the above problems. It is general and efficient method of shift-reduced parsing. It is used in a number of automatic parser generators. Third, the LRK parsing technique was introduced by Knuth in 1965, which is L, where it stands for left to right scanning of input, where R represents rightmost derivation done in reverse, and K is the number of look ahead symbols used to make parsing decisions. Four LR parsing techniques will be considered: LR0, LR parsing with no look ahead token to make parsing decisions, SLR1, which is a simple LR with one token of look-ahead. LR1, which is a canonical LR with one token of look-ahead. And LALR1, which is a look-ahead LR with one token of look-ahead. LALR1 is the preferable technique used by the parser generators. And last but not the least, LR is attractive for a number of reasons. It is the most general deterministic parsing method known. It can recognize virtually all programming language constructs. It can be implemented very efficiently. And the class of LR grammars is a proper subset of the LL grammar. It can detect the syntax error as soon as the erroneous token is encountered. And an LR parser can be generated by a parser generating tool. Next slide. So let us talk about LR parser. An LR parser consists of driver program, same driver which is used for all LR parser, parsing stack. It contains the state information where SI is state I, and states are obtained from gram analysis. Next is parsing table, which has two parts: action section, which specifies the parser actions, and go to action, which indicates the successor states. The parser driver receives token from the scanner one at a time. Parser uses stop state and current token to look up parsing table. And different LR technique produce different table.
So here we are going to discuss about LR0 parser. The LR0 parser is an efficient bottom-up syntax analysis technique that can be used to large class of context-free grammars. L stands for left-to-right scanning, R stands for rightmost derivation in reverse, 0 stands for number of input symbol of look-ahead. Steps of LR0 parsing. First is augment the given grammar. Second one is draw conical collection of the LR0 item. Third one is create the parsing table, and fourth is stack implementation, and fifth is draw parse tree. And here we are going to see an example to understand steps of LR parsing better. Here a grammar is given where E and B are B are terminals and C and D are terminals. And let's we have to generate the string.
C and D terminal. D for Delhi.
So here let's see your example to understand LR0% better. Here E and B are non-terminals and C and D are terminals, and we have to generate the string CCDD from the grammar. So the first step is augment the given grammar. So what is the given grammar? What is the augment grammar? If P is a grammar with starting symbol S, then G dash is a grammar with a new starting symbol S dash, and the production is S produces S dash. We can say augment grammar is adding a additional duplicate grammar to, and here we have added E dash produces E in the grammar. And the second step is draw the conical collection of LR0 item. And LR0 item is a production G with dot at some position on the right side of the production. LR0 item is useful to indicate that how much of the input has been scanned up to a given point in the process of parsing. As we can see, we have put a dot before E in the production E dash produces E. So we have now we have to explore the E. So we put it E B dot before BB and B produces dot CB and dot D. Now look at step state 0. Here we can see E dash produces dot E. There is no production left, so it goes to I0. And in the second production, we have to explore the second B. So it produces B produces dot CB and dot D. And the third production, that is B produces dot CB, we have to shift the dot from before B. So we explored B and it becomes B produces dot CB and dot D. And we named it as state 3. And the last production, that is B produces dot D, there is no production left to explore. So we named it as state 4. And now we can see from state 2, we have explored the second B and it goes to the state I5 and becomes E produces BB dot, and from the production B produces dot CB, we have to shift the conical we have to shift the C from we have to shift the dot from C to B. So we explore the conical item. We have to explore the B and the C goes to step 3. And in step 3, from step 3, B goes to the state 6, that is B produces CB, and the second production, that is B produces CB slash dot D. The C creates a self loop and D goes to the state I4. And here is the review of canonical collection of LR0 item. And here we have added an additional step, that is number the production to create the parsing table. Now see the steps of creating parsing table. If a state is going to some other state on a terminal, then it corresponds to a shift move. And if a state is going to some other state on a variable, then it corresponds to go to move. And if a state contains the final item in the particular row, then write the reduction node completely. So here we have created the parse table with the help of the canonical collection, and the input is CCDD as mentioned earlier. Now we have to see state 0. In state 0, we can see C produces state 3 from state 0. So we have to see C in the stack and go to the state 3. And now we have put it C followed by 3 as it produces state 3. Now we have to check in the state 3. And as we can see, C produces state 3 from state 3. So we have so we shifted C and followed by state 3. And it becomes C3. Now the double D are left in the input. So we have to check state 3. And as we can see, D produces state 4. So we have shifted D and followed by 4. And now, as we can see, only D is left. Now we have to check in state 4. D produces state 4. So we have written D4 and D4. And now we have to check in state 4. We can see in the action part there is reduced D, that is B produces D. So we have reduces the D with B. And now for the number we have to check in reverse order. So we can take a look to state 3, as 3 is before B. And as we can see, they are in the state 3, there is 6 in the B. So we have put it step 6 there. Now as we can see, in the state 6 there is reduction 2 is happening, that is B produces CB. So we have reduces the grammar CB to B, and looking in the state 0, there is state 2 producing from B. So we have put it 2 behind B. And now as we can see, from in the state 2, from state, and now we have to shift the D. As we can see, state 2 in D produces the state 4. So we have shifted the D and go to the state 4. And in the and we have shifted D followed by the 4. Now as we can see, in the state 4, reduction 3 is happening, that is B produces D. So we have reduces the D with B, looking in the reverse order, that is state 2, there is in state 2 there is B below 5, so we have put it set 5. Now as in the state 5, there is reduction 1 happening, that is E produces BB. So we have replaced BB with an E. And now as we can see, in the state 1, the acceptance is happening, that's why the string got accepted, as there is no input remaining in the stack. And the last part is making the parse tree. We have to make the parse tree from the below of the stack table. As we can see, E produces 2 B's, so we have put it 2 B's, and then 1 B produces D, and another B produces C and B, and then 1B produces C and B, and which B becomes D further. So as we can see, the stack the 3 is implemented, and the grammar CCDD is produced.
C took the closure to reduce the number 5 is considered the augmented grammar given below. Is dash. The answer is 3. Answer is 5, because in the all in this stage the number of items it in go to is 5. That's why the answer is 5.
So SLR is a simple SLR is a stands for a simple LR parser, and it is the smallest class of grammar having few number of states. Smallest class of grammar having few number of states, and SLR is very easy to construct and is similar to LR parsing. The only difference between SLR parser and LR zero parser is parsing table, and there a chance to shift reduced conflict because we are entering reduced corresponding to all terminal state, and we can solve this problem by entering reduced corresponding to follow of LHS of production in the terminating state, and this is called SLR collection of item. And there are a few steps of constructing the SLR parsing table, and the first one is writing augmented grammar. Second one is LR0 collection of items to be found, and find follow of LHS production, and defining we are defining to find two function. First one is goto and second one is action, and in this parsing table. And there are the given grammar, which is A produces A plus B and B, and A produces B and B start T, and B produces T and T produces terminal B. And we are following some rule, and the terminal of this grammar are small b, and the non-terminal of the this grammar are capital S, capital A and capital B. So we are following some rules. If any non-terminal has a dot preceding it, we have to write all its production and add dot preceding each of its production. And rule number two is from each state to the next state, the dot shift to 1 plus to the right. So here we are added a augmented grammar, which is S dash following a producing dot A. So here we can see this. This is our starting point. So the if I shifted a dot after A, so here we can see this is a starting step. And if I shifted a dot after A, we find S producing A dot, which is reach the final state, and A producing A dot plus B. And if we are shifting B, it will become A producing B dot, and B producing B dot start T. And shifting T, we will have B producing T dot, and we will shift terminal B, we will have B producing B dot. And in this grammar, if we shifting plus, we will have A producing A plus dot B, and there is a dot preceding capital B. That's why we should open all the production of capital B. And here is the production of capital B. Capital B producing dot B start T, and B producing dot T. And here are also dot preceding capital T. That's why we should open all the production of capital T, and that is T producing dot small b. And in this case, the star shifting and we will, it will become B producing B star and dot T, and we should open all of the production of capital T and T, and we will have T producing dot small b. And in this grammar, if we will shift B, we will find A producing A plus B dot, which will become the final state, and B producing B dot start T. And in this grammar, if we will shift T, we will find this grammar again, and if we will shifting small b, we will find this grammar again. And in this state, if we will shift T, we find
this
B
state.
This state.
Not this grammar state.
So in this state, if we will shift T, we will find B, which is producing B star T dot. And in this state, if we will shift star, we will find this grammar state again. And if we will shift small b, we will find this state again. And so there are the state three. And we will build a parsing table. So side to the answer. So as we can see from state I zero, the small b produce state four and capital A goes to state one, and the terminal B goes to state two, and T goes to state three, and in I one. State plus produces S5 and S produces A dot is our augmented grammar. That's why we put accept here. And in I2 there are a final state, so we should find the follow of A. So the follow of A is plus and dollar, and this is our second grammar. That's why we put R2 in the below of plus and below of dollar. And in I3 B produces T dot, which is reducible. So the follow of B is star plus and dollar. That's why we put R4, because the that is our fourth grammar. So we put R4 in the below of plus, star and dollar. In I4, in the same way, we put R5 because the our this is our fifth grammar. So the follow of T is star plus and dollar. That's why we put R5 in the below of plus, star and dollar. In state I5, B goes to state 4, and non-terminal B goes to state 7, and T goes to state 3. And in I6, B goes to state 4, and T goes to state 8. In I7, star goes to state 6, and there are also a final state. Which is T producing B. Sorry, sir. So in state I7, star goes to state 6, and there are also a final state which is A producing A plus B dot, which is our first grammar. That's why we put R1 in the follow of A, which is plus and dollar. And in the state I8, there are a final state which is our third grammar. That's why we put R3 in the follow of T, which is plus, star and dollar. And further will proceed by
in this given grammar, the symbol less than is not present. Hence, the respect to less than, there is neither a seek reduce conflict or reduce conflict. However, the respect to symbol greater than, there is a reduce shift conflict. If we consider the grammar to LR0, we SLR conflict the given canonical from. Suppose that the present state is LR0 and the transition on greater than is go to state 1 state, then S imply S L greater than R produce the number 1 and the Q produce R closer. The production number is 2. In LR0, the reduce move will be placed in the entire row under the terminal column. Hence, the one symbol greater than there will be a SR conflicts. Grammar is ambiguous, but there are a certain ambiguous grammar that are not SLR1 and S2 for any constant free grammar. There are a parser that takes a most O in NQ time to parse a thing for length N. S3, S1 is 2 and S2 is 2. Next, every SLR grammar is ambiguous, but there are a certain ambiguous grammar that are not SLR1. As you can see the diagram, not all ambiguous grammar is SLR, but the all SLR grammar is ambiguous. This is true. For statement true, for the any context free grammar, there are a parser that take in the most OMQ time to parse a string of length n. This statement is also true, but there are a standard algorithm for general context free grammar known as